Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome this evening. I would ask you to please rise and stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and National Anthem to be led by Elizabeth Antenovich, class valedictorian, and to be performed by the Timberlane Regional High School Select Ensemble under the direction of Mr. Rob Harrington.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome you to Timberlane Regional High School and the Class of 2004 Scholarship Night. On behalf of the staff at the high school, I would like to thank all of the presenters who are here this evening and all the businesses and organizations who are donating money on behalf of the education of our students. I'd like to start off the evening with a brief quote from Abraham Lincoln. A child is a person who is going to carry on what you have started. He is going to sit where you are sitting. And when you are gone, attend to those things which you think are important. You may adopt all of the policies you please, but how they are carried out depends on him. He will assume control of your cities, states, and the nation. He is going to move in and take over your churches, schools, universities, and corporations. The fate of humanity is in his hands. The group of individuals we have here this evening that we are honoring are just those kinds of individuals. They are students at Timberlane Regional High School who have shared their dreams with us and who have succeeded in accomplishing those dreams. In about 48 hours, we will be turning over the fate of humanity to their hands. I hope you enjoy this evening. And we would like to continue the program with the presentation of scholarships.
I'd like to get the program started right away by inviting Ann Holder up here to present the Adventure Law Scholarship tonight.
Adventure Lore is very proud this year to give out two scholarships to two students from the Danville Elementary School, Timberlane Regional Middle School, and now the Timberlane High School. And these two recipients are Jillian Krotz and Brandon Marceau.
Yeah, Brandon.
Woo!
Yes, Jill.
All right, I'll be giving out the Atkinson Academy PTA scholarships. I have no affiliation with the Atkinson Academy PTA, but their presenter is not here yet, so. The Atkinson Academy PTA scholarship would like to award Michael Epstein and Jillian Derriman. Our next presenter will be Stuart Davis from the Atkinson Lions Scholarship.
The Atkinson Lions Club Scholarship recipients are Kiera Piano and Jillian Dierman.
Next up is the Atkinson Women's Civic Club Scholarship, which will be presented by Mary Beth Tarosian.
Each year, the Atkinson Women's Civic Club awards scholarships to four graduating seniors from Atkinson. This year's recipients are Joshua Nye, Ryan Foley, Margaret Deal, and Lauren Fournier.
Throughout the evening, we'll be providing some senior salutes, which I believe is a tradition here at Timberlane Regional High School. We modified it a little bit this year. This senior salute is basically a nice round of applause for the particular person or group of people being recognized. So I guess we'll start things off with a special senior salute to your fearless, hardworking, caring, and wicked awesome class advisors, Mr. Ray Moore, Mrs. Lorraine Mascioli, and Mr. Michael Zimian. Okay, moving on will be the Atkinson Women's Garden Club Scholarship, which will be presented by Mrs. Gina Winchell.
On behalf of the Atkinson Garden Club, the scholarship's gonna go to Michael Lynch.
Okay, we'd like to now invite Gail Murphy up to present the Danville PTA Scholarship. Hi, I'm Gail Murphy. All right, The Danville PTA Scholarship would like to recognize Jillian Kratz this year. Harrington Memorial Scholarship, which will be presented by Mr. Donald Woodruff.
It is my honor to tonight present the Chris Harrington Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student who shows character, honor, resolve, integrity, and spirit. First letters, those words all spell out the name Chris. Chris would be so honored to see the quality of the students that are awarded this in his name. This year's recipients are Danielle St. Gelay, Elizabeth Hyde, Justin Burden, Mike Vaccarello.
To invite our very own math whiz up, Mrs. Noreen Burns, to present the next two scholarships, the Ronald Hazeltine Scholarship, as well as the Daniel Ketchin Scholarship.
I think we have a lot of math whizzes sitting down here tonight. That's what I think. I didn't know I was going to give the Ron Hazeltine Scholarship. Marilyn Pearl was supposed to be here to do the honors. But I remember Ron Hazeltine when I first came here to Timberlane, and let's see, there were three A's that come to mind: academics, athletics, and attitude. And on behalf of Ron Hazeltine and his family, I'm honored to present the scholarship to Amanda Nye. Yeah. The student body gets together on Pi Day, which is March 14th, to sell pies and to celebrate the memory of a former colleague of mine and my former boss, Dan Ketchum, math department chair whose shoes that I will never fill. He taught us every single day when he came to work about perseverance and love of what we do every day. And I am very honored this year to present two scholarships, because we sold a lot of pie, to Dan to Anthony Jigogian and Dima Centilovich.
Presenting the Jennifer Klink Scholarship, and that scholarship goes to Daniel Belmore.
Yes.
said, "Thanks, sweet." All right. Now I'd like to introduce Mrs. Diane Nye to present the Eric C. Lovett Memorial Scholarship.
On behalf of my family, it gives me great pleasure to present the scholarship to a senior football player who always has a smile on his face and always is having a good time, much as my brother was in his senior year. Our scholarship goes to Clifford Elston.
I'm not too sure if Corporal Pascal is here, is he? In the U.S. Marine Corps? No. Okay. I will just mention the names. They don't have to come up here. I think they were awarded this before. But the Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Awards this year go to Anthony Riccio and Katie Sickle. You guys can stand up. And our Marine Corps Scholastic Excellence Award will go to Catherine Underwood and Justin Byrd, if you guys could stand up as well. The next scholarship is the Madden Scholarship, and this year the Madden Scholarship would like to recognize Andrew Medeiros. Our next senior salute goes to your senior class executive committee members for all their hard work and diligence throughout the past years. In no particular order. Actually, it's alphabetical. Justin Burden, if you guys could stand up, please. Vice President Caitlin Cornell. Dan Desmond. Student Council Liaison Jill Dayerman. Treasurer Michael Epstein, Student Council Liaison Megan Lemieux, Ashley Rochford, President Daniel St. Gelay, Brianna Smith, Secretary Larissa Smith, and Danielle Reedman. All right, I'd now like to invite the McSheehy family up to present the McSheehy Memorial Scholarship.
Good evening. Wow, it seems like yesterday I was sitting where you are, but that was a long time ago. Mr. Woodward was actually my eighth grade teacher, I believe. If you went to public school over the last 28 years, you know my mother, Mrs. Terry McSheehy, affectionately known by the younger children as the library lady. If you've attended any of the last 25 school class nights, you've known her as a member of the scholarship committee. If you've lived in Plastow or the Timlin District over the last 46 years, you may know my mother for her commitment to various organizations, the majority of which centered around children. Children were my mother's passion, and each of the hundreds and thousands of children she touched individually, one child, one book, one birthday card, one white tear, one word of encouragement at a time, are the best, and they are all better because she genuinely cared. When my mother was ill this spring, she received a beautiful bouquet of flowers sent anonymously from someone and signed simply, "The Children of Plastow." She was deeply touched by that gracious act because she was genuinely surprised that anyone acknowledged all that she had done. When she passed away this spring, we were overwhelmed by the outpouring of cards and notes, many from former students and their families recounting their love for her. We loved her as our mother, but we didn't even come close to realizing how many lives she had anonymously touched in such profound ways. My mother raised a family, worked outside her home, volunteered in her community, and used her passion for children to make her community a better place for generations of children. If she were here tonight, she would want us to challenge each of you graduates here to use your passion, whatever that passion is, to realize your dreams, but in doing so, to also make your community a better place for the next generation.
Several years ago, my wife Tammy and I began discussing the idea of starting a family scholarship as a way to give back to the community that have been so good to us. Though she's not here tonight, we are here as a family to make that dream come true. And this year, the recipients for the two Tammy McSheehy scholarships are Megan Lemure and Edward Blair.
I would now like to introduce Mr. Chris Ingalingo from the Mr. Tuck Scholarship.
Good evening. Mr. Tuck's has been family owned and operated for over 55 years. This is our scholarship's sixth year in helping high school students further their education. Along with Hollywood Tans, iParty, University Cap and Gown, Arthur Murray, Class Rings by R. Johns, Vacation Outlet, and Bradford Carpet One, Mr. Tux is pleased to present $1,000 to one of 50 recipients this year, Anthony Jirigoshin.
Anthony will also be going to Fenway Park to receive a scholarship. I guess he gets it awarded on the pitcher's mound before a game. So. I'd now like to introduce Dennis D. Shane, who will be presenting the Plastow Fish and Game Scholarship.
Pay attention, kids. When you get to college, life is very, very expensive. Plastow Fish and Game Club awards our annual Harold B. Kidder Scholarship to Rachel McGregor.
I'd now like to invite Mr. Dennis Doucette up to present the Plastow Lions Club Scholarship.
On behalf of the Plastow Lions, I'd like to present these two scholarships to Megan Lemieux and Andrew Medeiros.
Thank you.
All right, everybody on your best behavior, because Officer Joan Marsilia is coming up to present the Richard Shields Memorial Scholarship.
Good evening. On behalf of the Plaistow Police Association, it's my absolute honor to award the Richard Shields Scholarship to Danielle St. July.
The Laura A. Raza Scholarship will be presented by our very own Joan Stern Sterner.
God, you're so creative. You start in September and you made me this cheese Danish garnished with this royal vanilla icing. And then you moved on to a French pate choux stuffed with a raspberry chocolate mousse and dusted with almond praline. And then there was the maple barbecue chicken finished with a warm piece of apple pie and caramel ice cream. And then I can't forget that roast pork tenderloin with a cranberry chipotle glaze. And then your grand finale was your mom's baked ziti in her special sauce, topped with chicken parmesan, and then the Italian vanilla gelato. It was breathtaking. Now, I know what you really wanted for graduation was a box of ramen noodles. But would you settle for a scholarship instead? I am honored to present the Laura A. Raza Scholarship to Jeff Hodgkins.
Invite up one of my personal heroes, Mr. John Leary, who will be presenting the Ann Reardon Memorial Scholarship.
I'm both honored and humbled to present this scholarship in loving memory of my former colleague and good friend, Ann Reardon. Tonight, the Ann Reardon Memorial Scholarship is awarded to two students who strongly exhibit the qualities of citizenship, leadership, service, and honor. These are the qualities Mrs. Reardon encouraged her students to strive to embody, and which she herself tried to model for them. Tonight's scholarship recipients achieved Mrs. Reardon's goals. They each embody the qualities of citizenship, leadership, service, and honor, and they have modeled these qualities for our school community. I hope we can continue to offer this scholarship in future years, but however long it is offered, tonight is special because the recipients tonight worked closely with Mrs. Reardon as members of her beloved student council. I am very happy, and I know Mrs. Reardon would be overjoyed to offer the Ann Reardon Memorial Scholarship to Brittany Manso and Tiffany Tebow.
I'm now pleased to invite Mrs. Patricia Roman up, who will be presenting a scholarship in honor and memory of her son, Daniel Roman.
The Daniel F. Romanoff Memorial Scholarship, which we established in our son's name, honors more than just his memory. It honors his spirit. Dan was a sophomore when he died in an automobile accident last May. While as parents, we always knew that Dan was a good person, we learned that he was that and more from those who knew him best, his teachers, his coaches, his fellow classmates, and his friends. We heard about Dan's willingness to step in and to help a stranger who may have been different or less popular. We learned how very many lives he touched by respecting people's individuality and by daring to make kindness cool. Throughout the year, I've asked teachers to nominate students who exhibit character traits similar to those shown by Dan and who have quietly touched lives the way that he did. Many may not even have been known that they were nominated for this scholarship. The descriptions of these nominees have been given to us without names and most times without reference to gender or other identifying characteristics. Sorting through these recommendations was a difficult task, but a gratifying one. So many of you in this school have so many great and giving spirits, something that we as the Romanoff family have seen firsthand. But tonight, it is my honor and my privilege to single out one deserving student and to award the second annual Daniel F. Romanoff Memorial Scholarship to Jake Gardner.
I'd now like to invite Brenda Merrill up to present the Sandown Fifth Grade Scholarship.
This scholarship was actually supposed to have been presented by Hannah Knutman, who is a fifth grader, and she's the student council president at Sandown Central School. Unfortunately, I think she's still at soccer tryouts right now. So on her behalf and on behalf of all of the fifth grade class at Sandown Central School, I would like to present this scholarship to Amanda Frazier.
Okay, the Sandown Lions Scholarship will now be presented by Jerry Dugas.
Good evening. It's indeed my pleasure to be representing the Sandown Lions Club here tonight to congratulate the parents, the teachers, and especially this graduating class of 2004. Be proud of your accomplishments thus far and look forward to your future works. I get to present two awards tonight. First goes to our ninth annual scholarship award winner. Whereas our motto in the Lions is we serve, we select the Sandown graduate who most typifies this spirit of volunteerism in making his or her community a better place. This year's award winner does exactly that, Ms. Melissa Falkenhahn. Member of this graduating class who we'd like to recognize has been an associate Sandown Lion for many years. An associate Lion is one who is too young to be an official Lion, but who helps at events and projects we are involved. This young lady has shared her wonderful musical gift at our suppers. She has brightened these suppers with her efforts and with her smile. Thank you, Ms. Carolyn Caldwell.
Thank you. Now I know what that loud bang was. I had no idea. I thought it was Jay Gardner falling from the ground. All right, I'd like to give another senior salute to anyone who's been involved in our exceptional and tradition-winning sports and athletic programs here at Timberlane Regional High School. Too many accomplishments to mention. Senior athletes, would you please stand for your senior salute? Moving on tonight, we will be at the Sandown Old Home Day Scholarship, which will be presented by Mr. Mark Traeger.
And Ted Windglass.
And that's me, and that's Mark. This is a new scholarship from the town of Sandown, and it came out of our Old Home Days committee. But it's really sponsored by the Sandown Road Runners, which runs the 5K race during the month of August. The award goes to two Sandown students that demonstrate academics, athleticism, and community service.
And I'm honored to award these to two kids that I've seen grown up over the years. I know their families well and didn't pick these people. The scholarship committee picked them. They go to Ashley Roachford and Jeffrey Clifton.
I'd like to get Brenda Merrill up here one more time to present the Sandown PTA Scholarship. Along with the little Knutton.
Well, look who's here straight from soccer tryouts. On behalf of the Sandown PTA, it is our pleasure to present the following two students. Both of these students both attended and graduated from Sandown Central School, and they are?
Jeffrey Clinton and Brianna Smith.
Timberlane Community Band Scholarship will be presented tonight by the father of this house, Tony DiBartolomeo.
You never know. You turn a mic on and everyone becomes a comedian. Nice job, Mr. Kyle. It's my pleasure and honor to present the second annual Timberlane Community Band Scholarship on behalf of the Executive Committee of the Timberlane Community Band. The criteria for this scholarship is one that student who's made a significant contribution to the Timberlane High School Music Department and plans to continue his or her education in the field of instrumental music. This year's recipient is Mr. James Michael Clark.
Personal hero of mine up here, Mr. Tony Hanscom, who's going to present the TTA scholarship.
On behalf of the Timber Lane Teachers Association, it is my honor to present this scholarship to Elizabeth Howard.
Timber Lane Regional High School Athletic Council scholarships will now be presented by my former seventh grade math teacher, Mr. Bucky Tata.
We won't say how he was in school. Also, I didn't know that Mr. D was the father of this house. I thought he was the grandfather. All right, it is my pleasure to give out four scholarships from the Athletic Council to the following people. First, Justin Burden, Amanda Nye, Mike Vaccarello, and the fourth two, Brianna and Larissa Smith.
I'd now like to invite Mrs. Nancy Gazzardi up here to give out the Timber Lane Regional Baseball Booster Scholarships.
The Timber Lane Baseball Boosters is proud to present four scholarships this year to Oscar Hain, Billy Post, Chris Murphy, and Mike Vaccarello.
I'll be presenting the Basketball Booster Scholarships tonight. This year's scholarships go to Katie Sickle, Justin Hoover, and Sam Keith. Another senior salute, a heartfelt senior salute, now goes out to our patient, tolerant, uncomplaining, and unwearied lunch ladies, custodial staff, and outdoor maintenance crew. They may not be here tonight, so if you see them again in your lifetime, please thank them. Moving right along to the Timber Lane Regional Cheerleading Boosters Scholarship, I'd like to invite Mrs. Irene Ray up to the podium.
On behalf of the Timber Lane Cheerleading Boosters, we would like to award the following scholarships: Megan Bordelace, Kelly Donahue, Amanda Frazier, Rachel Sylvester, Danielle Reedman, Catherine Underwood. We would also like to give special recognition to two senior athletes who contributed 8 seasons of cheerleading on the varsity squad, Kristen Carrs and Amanda Nye.
Woo! And you have children, this is a major night out. So I'd like to invite Mrs. Emily Morrison up here to present the Timberland English Honor Society Scholarship.
Yes, my baby's teething, so this is great. The English Honor Society would like to award this scholarship to two young women who have demonstrated through the past 4 years their obvious love of English and of other people. My great pleasure to invite Rhiannon Trzelnik and Chrissy Pralia.
Okay, the Field Hockey Booster Scholarship will now be presented by Mrs. Jane Clavette.
On behalf of the Timberland Field Hockey Boosters, I'd like to present the following 13 scholarships. Stephanie Barrett, Courtney Buttery, Whitney LaCroix, Brittany Manso, Kayla Pingree, Melissa Royer, Larissa Smith, Brianna Smith, Tiffany Tebow, Kristen Callio, Megan Lemieux, Katie Sickle, and Holly Winchell.
Building next year. All right, the Timberland Regional Football Booster Scholarship will now be presented by Mrs. Nancy Gazzardi.
Well, the Football Boosters is proud to present 9 scholarships tonight, with one additional scholarship in honor of the Romanuk family in memory of Danny Romanuk. And the 10 recipients are Jeff Hodgkins, Mike Zaccarello, Aaron Elston, Chris Murphy, John Patterson, Justin Hoover, Billy Post, Joel Paella, Justin Burden, and Pat Walsh.
This one. say a monstrous senior salute now goes out to those teachers, counselors, coaches, and administrators who have in some way impacted your life in a positive way. Would all the teachers, counselors, coaches, and administrators please stand up for your senior salute? Okay, I'd like to invite Mr. Robert Strada, who will come up and present the Timberlane Youth Football Tornadoes Scholarship.
The Timberlane Tornadoes Football and Cheerleading Organization is proud to present four scholarships this evening to two football players and to two cheerleaders. Having observed these folks in their younger days, I can tell you that the Tornadoes organization is very proud of their performances when they were with the Tornadoes organizations, and also very proud of their performances as they went on throughout their high school career. The two football players recipients are Justin Burden and Jeffrey Hodgkins. Cheerleading recipients are Amanda Nye and Catherine Underwood.
Now I'd like to invite Air Madsen, who will be presenting the TRHS GAP Scholarship.
Good evening. I'd like to do my own senior salute. First, I'd like three senior women to stand up. Mr. Kiley said that in 48 hours we'll be taking over the world. These three girls are going to be leading the charge. In 72 hours, I'll be taking 16 students to Germany for 1 month. And these three senior girls will be accompanying their 13 fellow underclassmen. Would Lee and Lissy and Stephanie stand up? Ich möchte die folgenden vier Seniors heute Abend anerkennen. Sie haben über die letzten vier Jahre hohe Leistungen im Studium der deutschen Sprache gemacht und eine Liebe der deutschen Sprache und Kultur bewiesen. Deswegen ist es eine große Ehre, ein Stipendium an Ihnen zu verleihen. Quick translation. The German-American Partnership Program and the German Honor Society recognizes the following seniors for their four years of excellence in the study of German language, its people and culture. Each scholarship is awarded to Lauren Fournier, Caitlin Mason, and Lissy Smith.
I'd now like to invite Mr. Dave Vaccarella, who will be presenting the Hockey Booster Scholarships this evening.
On behalf of the Timberlane High School Hockey Boosters, I'm pleased to present scholarships to our seven graduating seniors this year. They are Casey Bolduck, Giovanni DiGiacomo, David Fuller, Eric Newton, Mike Link, TJ McMahon, and Mike Vaccarella.
Okay, the next two scholarships, the High School Music Association and the Middle School Music Scholarship, will be presented by Mr. Mark Elliott.
Good evening. The High School Music Association every year is proud to present three scholarships to students that will be going on with their music education. And this year they've chosen three wonderful students to go on with that. First one is Elizabeth Howard. Second is Andrew Medeiros. And the third is James Clark. High school section of the Music Association, the middle school also awards a scholarship to a student who will be going on and furthering his career in music. This year, that's Edward Blair.
Advisors up here to give out these senior class scholarships.
On behalf of the advisors, I'd like to say, first and foremost, we're going to miss you guys. You've been great, and your growth has been second to none. Thank you. We'd like to thank the scholarship committee for selecting the recipients of the 2004 scholarships. It gives us great pleasure not only to advise the class of 2004, but to award the three following scholarships. First, going to Aaron Carroll.
Hi, Mike Zemian, senior class advisor. Mr. Kelly, I think I was behind you in line at Taco Bell. Ich habe um Steve's Pizza gegessen. That translation is, I ate at Steve's Pizza. It was a couple hundred yards closer. Listen, I want to say one thing a few weeks ago that these seniors, a selfish individual tried to ruin something they've waited 12 years to have, and that was their senior prom. And this senior class in this community said one word to them, not. I'm proud of this class, I'm proud of your maturity. I love you and we love you. And it's with great honor that I give this 2004 senior class scholarship to a very special senior I had in class this spring, the lovely Jennifer Jones.
I think we'd be remiss in making sure that we didn't not only thank the community and all of you seniors, but I think we need one more round of applause for our unsung hero, Mr. Moore. And it gives me great pleasure to announce the third recipient of the class of 2004 scholarship to Daniel Desmond.
Mr. Some more didn't think I noticed, but he's got a brand new pair of Skechers on right now. Shiny. All right, I'd now like to invite Mrs. Mary Beth Tarosian to come up and present the Ski Team Booster Scholarship.
This year, the Ski Team is proud to be awarding 3 scholarships to graduating seniors who have shown drive, dedication, and motivation to the team. These seniors have set examples for the underclassmen to follow. Congratulations to following athletes. The first recipient is our first 4-year member of the team. She was captain of the team the past 2 years and holds several team records, including MVP, for 3 years in a row. I'm very proud to award the first scholarship to Jen Allen. Always had a can-do attitude. She was always striving to improve and became a powerhouse for the girls' team. This scholarship is awarded to Jill Dearman. Never gave up. She had the drive and determination to excel in the team, and her positive attitude was contagious to others. This scholarship is awarded to Ashley Roachberg.
A very special senior salute now for all the parents / guardians and family members in the audience. Seniors, you need to remember where you came from, and you need to remember who helped you get here tonight. Will all the parents and guardians please stand? Massioli back up here to present the staff scholarship.
This is a new scholarship this year. It means a lot to the staff to honor a student that I personally had in class, and we love her enthusiasm, not only in class, but also how much she helped us with our first Tourmaline Variety Show. I give great pleasure in awarding this to Julie Callahan.
Massioli gave an encore presentation of that country song that she sang the other day. All right, I'd now like to invite Mrs. Jennifer Libia to present the Student Council Scholarship.
As Mr. Leary mentioned, I had the wonderful pleasure to take over Student Council from Ann Reardon, who also was a colleague of mine, very close and dear person. This year's seniors were amazing. I went on maternity leave and they stepped right up and took over Spirit Week and a variety of other functions that were run while I was gone. And just the leadership and dedication and commitment to the school and service was just amazing. The criteria obviously being leadership and service. This year's recipients go to Brittany Manso, Tiffany Tebolt, and Kira Felina. Scott Strange up here, who will be presenting the Students of Service Scholarship.
Thank you very much. It's an honor and a pleasure to be here tonight. It was Margaret Mead who said, "Never doubt that a small group of committed individuals can change the world. Quite often they are the only ones who do." This has been the premise that drives the Timberlane Students of Service organization. And over the past 3 years, both of tonight's scholarship recipients have upheld this ideal, and it is my great pleasure and honor to present these scholarships tonight. The two recipients are Brittany Manso and Caitlin Cornell.
Right, the Timberlane District Support Staff Scholarship will now be presented by Mrs. Renee Beaulieu.
Good evening. On behalf of the Timberlane Regional Support Staff Association, we'd like to present two scholarships this evening. Would Victoria Kerman and Kristen Palio please come up?
Soccer Booster Scholarships will now be presented by Mrs. Brenda Laycock.
Brenda couldn't be here tonight, so Patty and I are doing it in her behalf. And on behalf of the Timberlane Soccer Boosters Club, we'd like to present 11 scholarships to our graduating soccer players. For the girls, our varsity captains, Maggie Deal and Nicole Dufresne.
Boys Scholarship, Joshua Browning, Adam Bruno, Jason Hilbert, Matthew Kozak, Matthew Michon, Anthony Riccio, Brandon Smith, Jared White, and Stephen Wright.
TYSL Youth Soccer Scholarship will now be handed out by Susan Holbert, and Hannah Knutman.
Trying to get more formal these days.
I'm happy to present the TYSL Youth Soccer League and Timberland Soccer Club scholarships to six kids this year, which is pretty exciting. I'm going to have Hannah read the names.
Bonnie Hewitt, Nicole Dufresne, Anthony Rico, Brandon Smith, Jared White, and Stephen Wright.
My final senior salute before Mr. Coker takes over for the second program. So a final senior salute for me goes out to any senior who has abided by all dress code policies and procedures for our Timberlands. Would you please stand if you haven't been written up for a dress code violation of the last 4 years? Let's get the lights on. Okay, I will be presenting the Tennis Booster Scholarship tonight, and the recipients are Jennifer Allen, Jillian Dermond, Biz Hyde, James LaValle, Nikki LaVey, Katie Sickle, and George Valvanis. To invite Mrs. Cheryl to set up for the Volleyball Booster Scholarship.
Good evening. On behalf of the Timberland Volleyball Boosters, I'd like to present the following scholarships to Jillian Kratz, Kristen DeRosia, and Monique Lambert.
I'd now like to invite Mrs. Nancy Walker up to present the TRHS WorkSense Scholarship.
Thanks. This is a brand new scholarship, one that we hope we'll be able to continue for many years to come. And tonight I'd like to honor three students who gave up their free periods all year to come and volunteer in the Low Incidence Program. And it's because of their efforts that we were able to earn money to give these scholarships tonight. So it's my greatest pleasure to award scholarships to Aubrey Bond, James Margeson, and Alex Wilson.
Thank you. I'd now like to invite Mr. Robert Strada up here to present the Wrestling Boosters Scholarship.
The Timberlane Wrestling Boosters are very honored to provide two scholarships this evening. As a wrestler in the Timberlane Wrestling Room, there's two things you can do. You can work real hard on your individual skills to improve your personal performance, and you can work real hard in improving the skills of your partner and your teammates. And these two individuals, recipients, exemplify both of those qualities their entire careers here as part of the Timberlane Wrestling Team. I am very honored to provide these scholarships to Mr. Justin Burden and Mr. Billy Post.
Next on our program tonight is the Unitil Electric Scholarship, which is going to be presented by Mrs. Kimberly Long.
On behalf of Unitil Energy Systems, we would just like to say congratulations to the graduating class of 2004. Unitil Energy Systems presents four scholarships to the four high schools within our service territory. These scholarships are made possible by employee contributions as well as matched contributions by Unitil Energy Systems. This evening, I'm pleased to present one of those scholarships to Aubrey Bond.
Scholarship for the first program is the Walmart Scholarship, which is presented by Jackie Dornelles.
Anyway, good evening. My name is Jackie Dornelles, and I'm the Community Involvement Coordinator for Walmart here in Plaistow, New Hampshire. And education is very important to Walmart. We have a lot of students that work there, and we always are telling them, finish your education, it always comes first. Our founder, Sam Walton, always said, teach them and they will succeed. Their academic goals and achievements are very important. These young people are our future. I personally would like to take this time to tell the recipient of this Walmart Community Scholarship something, and I want you to know, if you have half the perseverance, the determination, the patience, and the understanding as your mother has, you will definitely succeed in life, and that's all I'm saying. And I'll let her tell you the rest of the story. But anyways, I am so proud to present the Sam Walton Community Scholarship to Kendra Bassey.
I'd now like to extend a warm welcome to our Timberlane Regional High School Select Ensemble, pianist Elizabeth Antanovich. They will be performing Bridge Over Troubled Waters, composed by Paul Simon, arranged by Kirby Shaw, and directed by Mr. Robert Harrington. Thank you.
I'll be your bridge over troubled waters.
down and out. When you're on the street, my love, when evening comes, so hard, I will comfort you. I'll take your part.
I'll be turning the microphone over to one of my personal heroes. He really is. The principal of your school will be providing the rest of the scholarships tonight, Mr. Charles Coker.
Let's give one more round of applause to Mr. Harrington and the Select Ensemble. It's my honor to continue with the rest of the program. The next scholarship is the Alumni Trust Scholarship. The awardee, Dmitry Sentilovich. Thank you. Next is the Atkinson Graphics Scholarship. The awardee, Adam Bruno. Scholarship is the Daniel T. Melanger Scholarship. The recipient, Nicholas Thornberry. Scholarship is the Jane Brown Scholarship. The recipient, Eric Knutton. The next senior salute is one that's very close to my own heart. And there are some very special people who are involved in it. A very special group of people that are probably way too numerous to mention. A huge senior salute now goes out to anyone in the community who was directly or indirectly involved in this year's 2004 re-prom. Again, way too many to mention. Please stand if you were on the re-prom team 2004. The next award is the Lieutenant Mark R. Caldwell Scholarship. The recipient is Miss Catherine Underwood. Scholarship is the Ruth B. Campbell Scholarship. The recipient, Larissa Smith. Scholarship is the Clifton and Ruth Cook Scholarship. The recipient, Mr. Jason Kissel. Is the J. Curley Memorial Scholarship. The recipient is Danielle Sikowski. The next scholarship is the Maud and John Dustin Music Scholarship. The awardee, Elizabeth Howard. Scholarship has two recipients. The scholarship is the Greek American Benevolent Scholarship. The recipients are Demetra Malonis and George Galvanis. Claudine Hanlon Scholarship. The recipient is Courtney Buttery. Is the Haverhill Rotary Scholarship. The awardee is Whitney LaCroix. Next is the Herf Jones Scholarship. The recipient is Elizabeth Antanovich. The next scholarship is the Frank Kelcourse Memorial Scholarship. The recipient is Justin Hoover. Another senior salute. A senior salute to all of our students out in the audience who have been involved in any co-curricular activity or club at some point in their high school career. Just to name a couple that may have not been named today, SAD, the Scribe, poetry, etc. Please stand if you've been part of any club throughout your years at Timberlane and get a senior salute. Just in case you might have any questions when the house lights didn't go up, my guess is probably almost every senior stood. One of the amazing things about this school is the number of organizations and clubs that we have and the number of students who are constantly participating. The next scholarship is the Thomas and Charlotte LaBosquette Scholarship. The two recipients are Joshua Browning and Caitlin Cornell. The next scholarship is the Liberty Grange Scholarship. The recipient is Kiara Flino. Scholarship is the Pace Scholarship. Two recipients, Anthony Jirigoshin and Brigitte Guy. Next scholarship is the PTSA High School Scholarship. This year there are four recipients: Michael Epstein, Brittany Manceau, Larissa Smith, and Tiffany Thibault. Next scholarship is the PTSA Middle School Scholarship. The recipient is Julie Callahan. Two scholarships go to the same recipient: the Plastow Auxiliary Fire Department Scholarship and the Plastow Historical Society Scholarship are both awarded to Justin Hoover. The next scholarship is the Pollard PTA Scholarship. The recipient is Courtney Buttery. Scholarship is the Region 10 Scholarship. The recipient is Aubrey Bond. Scholarship is the Seacoast Coca-Cola Scholarship. The recipient is Christopher Pasco. Next scholarship is Steve's Auto Body Scholarship. The recipient is Stephanie Barrett. Next scholarship is the TRHS Golf Boosters. There are four recipients of this scholarship. They are Keith Karen, Sam Keith, Brandon Marceau, and George Valvanis. Another senior salute. And now a very dramatic senior salute to our award-winning music and theater arts students in the audience tonight. Would you please stand if you've been involved in Timberlane Regional High School's music or theater arts program for your senior salute. To say that I spent three lovely days in New York with that group. The next award is the TRHS National Honor Society Scholarship. The winner is Catherine McKinnon. Next award is the TRHS Principals Scholarship. This year I changed it to two awards. The two recipients are Joshua Nye and Rhiannon Trollbeck. The next award is the TRHS Runners Booster Scholarship. This year there are six recipients: Dimitri Santilovich, Angela Paul, Keith Karen, Carolyn Kalbach, Daniel Desmond, and Brianna Smith. Scholarship is the TRHS SAD Scholarship. The two recipients are Amanda Nye and Danielle Wiedman.
Thank you.
The next award is the TRHS Softball Boosters Scholarship. This year, there are six recipients. They are Stephanie Barrett, Kelly Donahue, Amanda Nye, Catherine Underwood, Ashley Wade, and Holly Winchell. Scholarship that I have to award this evening is the Charisse May Holy Scholarship. The scholarship goes to Elizabeth Provencher. Senior salute, a very generous senior salute to all of the people and businesses in the community who have provided scholarship opportunities for the class of 2004 tonight. Let's give them a nice ovation for the generosity. I would also like you to notice on the back of your program other scholarships which students have been offered from outside agencies. Although there were not direct awards this evening, these are honors that our students have received. So if I could have the house lights, I'd like to run through those and ask those individuals to please stand. The Atkinson Girl Scouts, Julie Callahan and Kiara Flino. The Carl G. Davis American Legion Auxiliary Unit 34, Kathleen Jervis. The Chester College Scholarship, Wendy Myra. The Columbia International University Scholarship, Aubrey Bond. The Emory and Henry College, Justin Hoover. The Future Educators Academy Scholarships, Beth Provencher, Jillian DeArmond, Jesse Forsblad, and Kiera Flino. The Granite State Youth Soccer League Scholarship, Brandon Smith. The Greater Haverhill Chamber of Commerce, Brian DeArmond. The Haverhill Youth Bowling Scholarship, Andrew Medeiros. The Hesser College Scholarship, James Margison. The Lawrence General Hospital Scholarship, Tiffany Thibault. the Merrimack College Scholarship, Jason Kissel. The McDonald's Scholarship, Stephen Young. The Patrick Henry Scholarship, Justin Hoover. The Pilgrim Lanes Bowling Scholarship, Andrew Medeiros. Teamsters Local 25, Jason Hilbert. And the University of New Hampshire Scholarship, Andrew Medeiros and Tiffany Thibault. If there are other scholarships that were awarded to our students, my apologies for not naming them. Students were asked to come by the office and let us know what scholarships they were awarded. I'd like to turn the program over this evening for closing remarks to Mr. Woodworth. By the way, if you've noticed, it has been raining all evening. That was part of the compact. It could rain all day today, but not Thursday and Friday. Before sending you off into the rain, I thought I would say just a few things. First, to the parents and to this fine community, this year, between the orchestration of the second prom and the generosity that you have showered upon our most deserving students here tonight, the value of a supportive community has never been more evident. On behalf of the staff, I must tell you that your support of the students of this district and of the high school in this year in particular makes us proud, and indeed, we know we are fortunate to come to work at Timberlane High School. Thank you. And to the class of 2004, first of all, congratulations on a job well done. Secondly, I want to share an observation of mine. Your opportunities multiply as you seize them. Think about that. Your opportunities multiply as you seize them. Tonight is evidence that this has already proven to be true for all of you. You have taken advantage of the opportunities that we have to offer at Timberlane, and you have been recognized and rewarded for your efforts. And now it is time to take advantage of today's scholarships. I urge you to put your education, your energy, and your scholarship money to good use, to build upon the success that you've enjoyed at Timberlane, to take advantage of this opportunity to achieve your goals. Your futures are bright, so seize the day. All that said, good night. And thank you all for coming to Scholarship Night.